Uppercut, uppercut. Sonic Boom!
Well, hello there, humans of these earthlings, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever you're doing, and if you're lucky enough indeed to be doing it too. We're going to do a meta update here because Erangel has had massive changes over the last year or so, and some of those changes have been persistent and they've really influenced the way the map plays. This is very much different to the event mode. I'm not doing the event mode. I don't really like the event mode very much. I don't love the Spider-Man aspect of it. I don't love the buying stuff off the drop aspect of it. I don't like any of the gimmicks. I love classic Erangel. And one of the things I want to talk about is some of the tactics for these new spots on Erangel. I want to talk about the way you need to adjust your play style with this stuff. Some of the new hot drop zones, some of the new loot paths, all that kind of thing. So anyway, let's kick it off. You can see here, this is Rapunzel's Tower. Now, Rapunzel's Tower, this is, for me, the best way to defend if you're solo up here, is from the top of the box. The top of the box lets you see everything. It lets you dodge grenades. It's very, very cool. But Rapunzel's Tower is obviously not the only place. You get the guaranteed flare drop here, but there is also Gilligan's Island. This is in the bay, just to the east and south, southeast. Jeez, that's a good thing. Of Rapunzel's. One of the reasons I love this for a hot drop too is you can drop here, especially if you're solo squads. Get a squad wipe on the hot drop, and then you can just kind of third-party people over at the docks there that you can see just slightly to the north, or you can rotate easily from here to mill base. You can actually get a glider into the thermal and glide all the way to the rooftops of C block in mill base from Rapunzel's Tower, or you can rotate inland here. And there's heaps and heaps of vehicles, lots and lots of spawns along this pathway here. It's excellent. They've done so much to the map, but this particular set of new features has just been incredibly important for the game because now there is more traffic through here than ever before. It's middle map, which means most flight paths are going to touch it somewhere, either the tower or Gilligan's Island on one end or the other, and quite often both at the same time, as you can see with this flight path that I've got on the right of screen. But this is another thing. Like, people will throw grenades from down the bottom trying to get you from here, and if they know you're on the boxes, it's really difficult, and they hit the railings all the time and they kill themselves. And you can see the grenades when they pop up. Like, it's not hard. This is another duo pushing up. Yeah. Not good. Not good at all. It's a tough gig. And the reason I developed this strat here was because I got sick of people with DBSs killing. And you can drop straight down to the next level through there, which means they're generally watching the stairs and they don't see you when you drop down. They hide behind the crates. Where was I? So there's been other changes as well. The gliders obviously are all over the place here, which are really, really important. And this is the guy who kills himself with the grenade. But there's a lot of structures that have been put in around here, as well as buy stations. And there's a recoil center just between here and farm. All in all, it means that you get a lot more action off the hot drop. And not just off the hot drop, but throughout. When you get an automatic flare when you land here, that brings in a lot of people. Like, you know, we call it the milkshake. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard. Well, you put a flare up at Rapunzel's, you're going to get, it's more likely that a squad will push into you. And then you get this area at Gilligan's. This is what I'm talking about. So I'll edit footage and I'll wait for noise. And when I hear the noise, I'm like, where's that noise going from? Oh, it's going from there. And there'll be someone rotating in a boat. Like, I've seen more people in boats and killed more people in boats this season than every other season I've played PUBG Mobile combined. And that is not an exaggeration. I'm belting people in boats day in, day out, because this is my hot drop spot, du jour. This is my number one hot drop spot. And you'll hear the whole time that when people engage over there at the docks, you'll be able to rip them. This is the other one. Saveni.
Fuck, no.
They don't muck around Saveni. Yeah, they don't. Saveni's another one that's got very, very busy, but unlike... Unlike the hot drop area of the tower in the middle of the map, Saveni's a one-way hot drop. Like, you get a lot of people who will drop here, but they won't rotate in. or they'll move here late game if the circle shifts. And the reason for that is obviously people think it's on the edge of the map and there's like a room card that you can get level 3 gear. But that's not the case here. The case at Gilligan's is you can see me at 8 times the speed making rotations out. And by the way, I will always try and swim out of this place if it's very, very late and I'm coming into the circle, because the boats, you die with the boat getting blown up, and you die if you jump out of the boat and it's moving too fast. And people are not prepared for this crap. Like, they just are not prepared for this crap. And you've got to be willing to, like, really change the way you play and the rotations you make to be successful in this area. You've got to make a lot of use of really odd rotations, different features like boats and gliders. You've got to do a lot more swimming. It just conspires to make you a better player. If you're able to get outside the box, you can do really, really well. This is exactly what I'm talking about. People roll up mid-game to change vehicles. Like, there's vehicle spawns all along this road. People will drop at the edges of this Rapunzel's Tower, and they will drop here to not quite get involved. They want to sit in the Jimmy Barnes over there, the two blue barns, and they want to sit there and kind of snipe out of there, which is a terrible, terrible strat, by the way. It's a terrible, terrible strat. It doesn't result in a whole lot of joy. And what happens is they're like, it's like a cascade of mistakes. People will get drawn into those engagements that they have with other people. They'll hear the gunshots. They'll move all the way out of circle. And you can sit up here as long as you've got the circle, and you can just farm damage. Like, you can do so much work up here. It's sensational. You've got to be very, very careful from people rotating up from your east. People will drop docks and then rotate secondary. Or if you drop docks, quite often the squad from Rapunzel's Tower will rotate east to you and they will clear you up. It's very, very hard to rotate to Gilligan's Island. And if I was going to give any advice to someone attempting to rotate out of Gilligan's Island, or out to Gilligan's Island, I would say do it in the water if you at all can. You can be far more effective rotating up there in water than you can rotating in a boat. Rotating in a boat will just get you killed. There's no two ways around it. Here's our mate who grenaded himself. That's his crate down there. People make use of the elevators and all that. I find that very, very annoying. But this is turned into such a weird space. With the 400 meter changes to render range, you can see I'm whacking people up there. No problems. Just no problems. 370 meters away. Absolutely fine. He thought he was safe as houses. He went a little bit AFK there at the top edge and just got absolutely wasted. You'll also find that people will start rotating and switching cars here. Drops will come in, and you're able to just farm. You can work the numbers from down here, and you'll see gunfights will occur all the way along this road at car spawn swapovers. It's just the nature of the beast. And if you third party, you'll just do so much work. It's just a great, great way. This is another drop where I go, anytime you're seeing these drops, these kind of bits of footage where I'm solo squatting, I'm generally dropping Gilligan's or Rapunzel's and rotating out from there. From one to the other, quite often. I mean, there's 14 people left. There's buggies flying around. There's people shooting at me from the buy station area. It's an active place, and it's a fun place. And once you get the hang of the rotations and you get used to it, well, then you're so much better at working out of that tight spot. Look, I mean, this is from Gilligan's Island. This is all the way easily to the middle of Mill Base and a flare drop. And there's guys like just, they're absolutely not prepared. 100% not prepared for what's coming for them. And that's because you really do need to realize in this current version of Erangel, there are so many different ways to move around the map. We yeet all the time, yeet balloon into Rapunzel's. It's one of the best drop locations, and it's one of the most active drop locations you can go to. There's nearly always people here, and and it's just absolutely hectic. And the amount of people that will rotate in while you are already rotating in to fight the people that were here before is crazy. You can have games where there is just a non-stop smorgasbord of squads rolling into you here. And for a lot of people, that's not what they want. But it always surprises me how many people will drop these places and then try and leave. Like, why are you dropping here? You knew it was going to be rough. You knew it wasn't going to be an easy place to be. And yet, you drop here and you're like, oh, I'm going to leave now. And that's a bad idea. It's kind of like biting off a little more than you can chew and then seeing if you can chew it. That's what coming to these hot drops is like, and it makes you a much better player. I've been all about this season improving my game. I've been challenging myself. I've been playing solo squads all the time. I had like a 2K solo squad win today. I'm getting more squad wipes. I'm winning more gunfights. I'm playing a lot smarter. And I'm doing like a lot of quick peeks and little tap, tap, tap-a-roos. Yeah, that's right, baby. Once you start getting used to this playstyle and you start embracing the new Erangel kind of meta, you'll be so much better at the game and you'll lose. You'll die. And that's okay, because dying is what it takes to learn to live. Oh, Eastern mysticism. Don't fail me now. I'm Bushka. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you start hitting these hot drop locations and you start familiarizing yourself with the rotations out and the locations of the vehicle spawns and, you know, how to swim out. Make sure you're always boosted. You can move the shop to Malibu all the time as well. Like, Malibu is the houses on the point just to the east and slightly north of Gilligan's Island. And I mean, there's just so many busy places around here. They've really turned Erangel, the center of Erangel, into a hub for really active gameplay. And I think that's a huge testament to the boys and girls at PUBG Mobile who plan the maps and make it what it is today. Oh God, this place is so good for third partying. Like, I've already got 4 kills on the hot drop after the squad wipe. And here I am, just being an absolute grub, third partying and then editing videos in between third parties up on the top of the roof. Like, they made this place for me. Gilligan's Island, I wouldn't dare call it Bushka's Island, but it's definitely the place for me. It's where I go to get away from it all. You can see these poor grubs are all out there doing their best and I'm just sitting here tap, tap, tapping away. Oh, it's a story, baby. Until next time, look after yourselves. Please remember to like the videos, subscribe to the channel, all that kind of stuff. We've got a lot more stuff coming up that's going to be weapons-based. And yeah, until next time. Bye for now.